The human voice is created by air passing between the vocal folds, causing them to vibrate, resulting in sound waves. The vibrating vocal folds can be easily visualized with an endoscope passed through the nose. When observed from this top-down view, the vocal folds may initially appear to be V-shaped thin membranes that vibrate against each other. However, such a simplistic two-dimensional view is inadequate for a full understanding of the vocal folds' complex motion. Rather, when the vocal folds are seen in coronal view, instead of being thin band-like structures, they are actually wedge-shaped triangles. Furthermore, when the vocal folds vibrate against each other, there is both a horizontal and vertical component. During normal respiration, the posterior cricoarytenoid muscles move the vocal cords apart into an abducted position. This position allows air to freely pass during inhalation and exhalation. During phonation, the lateral cricoarytenoid muscles contract, bringing the vocal folds to the midline, a process referred to as adduction. Tracheal air pressure builds up below the adducted vocal folds as air is pushed up from the lungs. As the tracheal air pressure increases, it overcomes the resistance of the closed vocal folds, causing them to slightly part, beginning from the lower margins and forming a convergent shape. The minimum air pressure required to initiate vocal fold vibration is known as the phonation threshold pressure. The greater the perceived effort to produce the voice, the higher this pressure becomes, and the higher the potential for vocal hyperfunction. The combined effect of the sustained air pressure, the elasticity of the tissue, and the coupling of the lower and upper margins contribute to the progressive opening of the vocal folds from the lower margins until the upper margins separate. At this point, air is fully released between the vocal folds on its way and up towards the pharynx. As airflow flows, it accelerates as it passes through the glottis, resulting in a pressure drop due to the Bernoulli effect. This pressure drop causes the vocal fold covers to be pulled back together. As the lower edges of the vocal fold covers come back together, the upper margins are still apart in a divergent shape. Since they are connected and share the same elastic properties, they drag the upper edges to the midline. It is at this point that full closure of the vocal folds occur. The cycle is then repeated. Each air puff released during one complete vibration cycle is one cycle of the sound wave that we recognize as voice. It should be emphasized that this vocal fold oscillation is inherently asymmetrical, with a lag between the bottom and top edges of the vocal folds coming together. The vocal fold membrane or cover moves freely and separately from the vocal fold muscle as a result of the action of the air flowing through the glottis. This movement is wave-like, like a ripple over the surface of a pond, and it is known as the mucosal wave. Please keep in mind that the prior animation was exaggerated for clarity. In reality, only under certain phonation conditions will the part of the thyroarytenoid muscle, known as the vocalis muscle, actually move during vocal fold vibration as shown in this simpler animation. At normal loudness, note how the vocal fold membrane moves freely over the muscle. Vocal fold vibration itself is the product of muscle action, airflow dynamics, tracheal air pressure, and the interaction of the pliable vocal fold outer layers that overlie the body of the vocal folds. Changes in pitch can alter how the vocal folds vibrate. As pitch increases, cricothyroid muscle activation causes the vocal folds to elongate and thin out, reducing the difference between the upper and lower margins. Vocal fold vibration speeds up, resulting in more vibration cycles completed per second. The three-dimensional components of actual human vocal fold vibration can only be observed on high-definition, laryngeal high-speed video endoscopy recordings. Here is a video, courtesy of Dr. Eric Forrest, that illustrates this. Please note that the video is silent. Our voices are as distinct as our fingerprints, the result of many variables that contribute to the process of phonation. Seeing the complex patterns of motion of the vocal folds through high-speed video endoscopy supports our continued interest in understanding it in normal conditions and disordered states.